Before you begin, remove the base cover, audio module, heatsink, and M.2 solid-state drive. Removal. Carefully slide the two metal shields off of the tabs on the middle frame and remove. Turn the unit over. Lift the base cover off of the middle frame and remove. Disconnect the speaker from the connector on the system board. Disconnect the solid-state drive cable from the connector on the system board. Align the cutout in the base cover with the accessory module power port and place the base cover onto the middle frame. Turn the unit over. Remove the 5mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the system board to the middle frame. Carefully flex the rear edge of the middle frame and guide the external connectors on the system board out of the cutouts in the middle frame. Slide the system board out of the middle frame while flexing the edges of the middle frame where necessary. Remove the system board. Note: before installing a new system board, remove the following from the old system board and install onto the new system board. Memory boards, CPU, CMOS battery. Replacement. At an angle, tow the USB-C connector on the left edge of the system board into the cutout in the middle frame. Lower the system board while flexing the edges of the middle frame where necessary until the system board is in place and all external connectors are properly positioned through the cutouts in the middle frame. Replace the 5mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the system board to the middle frame. Turn the unit over. Lift the base cover off of the middle frame and remove. Connect the solid-state drive cable onto the connector on the system board. Connect the speaker cable into the connector on the system board. Align the cutout in the base cover with the accessory module power port and place the base cover onto the middle frame. Turn the unit over. Carefully slide the two metal shields onto the tabs on the middle frame. Important: after system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the device, updating the BIOS, updating DMI, and other settings,